So we're here today with Jeff Pittel, who's running for State Senate for the 12th District. How are you today?
Very well. Thanks for the opportunity to speak.
Well, thank you for coming. Can you tell us a little bit about what are the communities in the 12th District?
Well, the 12th District, the center is Pontiac and extends north to Independence Township and Clarkston, and then it extends east to Oxford Township, and then you also have Oakland Township. It extends south around basically Bloomfield Hills and includes Bloomfield Township.
Now, why have you decided to run?
I've decided to run because Libertarian is now a major party in the state of Michigan, and as such, we are trying to field as many candidates as possible. And I want to advance Libertarian philosophy and the message of Libertarianism to the population and have them give them an opportunity to vote for another party other than the two-party system, which seems to be dysfunctional at present.
Now, what are some of the specific issues that you'd want to take on?
Well, the major issue that is confronting the state and a large part of the state budget would be education. It's 40% of the state budget, and our education performance is very poor nationally, and I think we're basically in the bottom third now educationally as far as our standards, as far as our actually test results go. And it requires major reform to improve that, because we're not competing nationally, we're not, definitely not competing internationally. And it's a big issue as far as businesses not being able to secure properly qualified personnel, colleges having to provide remediation for students, and a whole host of issues associated with poor education, especially in our low-income communities.
Now, what would you do to fix that?
Well, I think we have to look at, you know, what are the options. The funding is obviously, everybody points to more funding is needed, but I think it's more choices needed. In other words, I would propose that a voucher system be implemented to allow parents and guardians to use vouchers to go to private schools, parochial schools, public schools outside the district, or even trade schools. I'd like to work with businesses to implement apprenticeship programs in lieu of just a high school bachelor or high school diploma. Part of that could be a trade school apprenticeship program.
Now, do you have any political background?
No, I don't. I've been active in the Libertarian Party for half a dozen years or so. I'm employed as an engineer currently at a major OEM. And this is my first foray into this political arena, and perhaps not my last.
Now, you mentioned being an engineer. Can you talk a little bit about what skills you've learned professionally that you would bring to this position?
Well, as an engineer, we are very data-driven people and fact-driven people, and engineering involves program management. Involves collaboration with a number of people and groups on a tight schedule within a constrained budget. So I think these qualities are very apt for the public sphere as far as you're dealing with the same type of situations, although it's not product development per se, it's policy development.
Now, you are unopposed in the primary, but come November you will be facing a Republican and a Democrat. Why should people vote for you?
The current political climate in the state and the nation is screaming for a third alternative to this bipartisan. It's not a bipartisan, it's basically two distinct parties that are vehemently opposed to each other. I think we can find common ground as Libertarians with Republicans and Democrats, so therefore we can act as more of a bridge between the two parties who are basically each other's enemies at this point, so there's no cooperation that we see in state or federal level.
Right, now, if people want more information about you or your campaign, where do they go?
I have a website that I've just developed. I'll be working on it as the campaign progresses. It is Jeff Pittel, and that would be JeffPittel, number 4, mi.org.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Thank you for the time, Crystal, and I hope to have another opportunity for an interview later before the general election. Thanks.